Students, today I am back with a new subject, that is EVS. Okay, today I am going to explain the lesson number 2, living with family. Living with family, as we know, we all are living with our family only, right? Yes. So let us see the topic here. Family. What is family? What is family? What do you mean by family? Family, a group of people who are related to each other, right? In a home, see, suppose one house is there, right? There, if we all are living like parents, children, right? We are, if cousins, uncle, aunts, and what, grandparents, if we are living together, then it's called as home, okay? If we are living in a one house, then it is called as a home. So family means what? Who are related to each other, not friends and all, okay? They are friends, but family members means they are related to us, okay? In the family only, there are two types, right? In family, there are two types. One is small family, another one is large family, yes? So in the last class, you have learned, right, about family and the kinds of the family, right? So let's talk about the small family. Small family. What is small family? Where parents and children live together is called a small family. Is called a small family. Yes. See, not our grandparents, cousins, where only our parents and siblings are living in a home, then it is called as a small family. Yes, it's called a small family. Then what is large family? What is large family? Where parents and children live with their grandparents is called as a large family. Yes, where people are living means only parents and children for that family we call small, okay? Where grandparents, parents and also what our siblings are living together is being it's called as a what? Large family. Where our parents are living with us, if our grandparents and siblings are living in a house, then we call it as a large family. Small means only parents and children. Large means grandparents, children and the parents. Okay. Next, extended family. What? Extended family means apart from our parents, there are many other people also living in our house. Is it? Yes. See here. A family that consists of the parents, children, grandparents, uncles, aunts and cousins live together in the same house is called extended or joint family. Yes, many of people are living in a joint family, right? With their uncle, aunt and cousins. Yes or no? Yes. Where small and large families are living? When the people got transferred somewhere, no? If they are in government servant, then they will shift to another place, right? That time people will stay in other place. They, for that family we call smaller, little large means if they are living with their grandparents, then it's called large family. But extended means, see, in our family, even I too living with in a joint family, you know, in my house also, my parents, my sister, my brother, and also my grandparents, my uncle, aunt, and cousins, we all are living happily in our family, right? Like that only, even your family also living, some of the people living in the joint family only, right? So, where grandparents, uncle, aunt, cousins, siblings, yes, these all are living together in the same house is called a joint family. Then what do you mean by uncle? For whom you call uncle? Yes, the brother of your mother or father are called what? Your uncle. Then aunt, the sister of your father or mother are called, is called what? What? Aunt. Then cousins, the children of your uncle or aunt is called what? Cousins. Yes. See, sometimes the brother of your sister or what, the brother of your mother or father, like your uncle or aunt, right? They stay somewhere else. Okay, then the extended family means where the grandparents, uncle, aunt and cousins, they are the member of the extended family. Yes. And also, in a single house, uncle and aunt are not living, right? Because some of the member of extended family, some members of the extended family, they live in other places. When we'll go and meet them? When special occasion will be there, that time on the festival or other celebrations or birthdays will be there, that time we'll meet them, right? We'll go to their place, we'll enjoy, we'll play with our cousins, we'll meet to all our family members, right? Then we'll come back to our house. Yes or no? Even here in your textbook also they have given, see here, nuclear family. Nuclear family is nothing but a small family. Nuclear family is nothing but small family. Large family is the one in which their children, parents and live together with their grandparents. Okay, extended family. Apart from our parents, grandparents and siblings, there are many other people in our family. Yes, I told you. Apart from our grandparents and parent, there are many other people like uncle, aunt and cousins. Yes, they will be staying with us, right? For them we call extended, member of the extended family. And here see the family tree, right? Grandma is there, grandpa is there, grandma again, dad and mom, okay, uncle, aunt, sisters and cousins, right? Siblings and cousins. This is the example of Yash family tree. Okay, you can make your family tree also, right? Yes, sometimes member of our extended family live in other places. We meet them on special occasions such as birthday, festival and other celebrations. Yes, no, it's not necessary to be in a one house only. Some member of the extended family live in other places. Then we will go there, we'll go to their place, we'll meet them on the special occasions, right? Then we'll come back to our house. Living together. See, in a family, all the members work together. Our parents look after us. They give us food, clothes, shelter. They take care of us when we fall ill. Yes. In our family, if in an extended family, if we are living like auntie, uncle and cousins, if we are living these many members, then we'll work together, right? Yes, we should work together. We should give, we should love to each other, right? Then only that family will become a happy, right? Like that only when our parents will take care of us, right? When we fall sick, they protect us from the danger. Yes, they give shelter. Again, what? Our parents look after us. Yes, and grandparents, uncle, aunt also look after us. They play with us and help us when we need them. We play with our sibling and cousins. Yes. Not only our parents, grandparents, uncle, aunt, cousins, they will also help us, right? Grandparents tell us a moral stories, right? And your uncle, aunt, they'll play with you. They plays with you again. What? Your cousins, with your cousins also you will play, right? They will also take care of us. They also take care of us, right? Like our parents only, they'll treat. We should also help out by doing small tasks. We should also help out by doing small tasks. We can make our bed every morning. We can put away our toys and books. We can also water the plants. Everyone should help and love one another in a family. A loving family is a happy family, obviously. You know, if we are living in a same house, then we should help to each other. We should share to each other. Yes, early morning when you wake up, then you should not disturb to anyone. You should make your work, you should do your work yourself only. You should make your bed, everything clean, and whatever things will be falling, know that you should keep on the proper places. Yes, and also we should water the plants whenever you will be free, right? We should help out to our what family. Yes, we should share everything. A loving family. Yes, if we know each other, if we share each other, then that family will become a happy. Then if we share the love also, that family will become happy. Then happy family, loving family is a happy family. Yes. Celebrating together. You know, children, in our India, so many festivals are there, right? Even we too celebrate so many festivals. Let us talk here. See, we celebrate many festivals in India. Festivals are a time of fun and joy. We wear new clothes and greet to each other. Family members cook special food. We share our food and gifts each other. Yes, we visit family members who live in other places and exchange sweets and gifts. Yes. See, if we are in a house, if our festival are coming, then how we feel? Yeah, our festival is coming, we should buy a new clothes, we should buy something, like new clothes, gifts, and you know, sweets, these all things we should buy. Then children will become happy, right? Children will become happy. That time what we will do? We'll wear new clothes, we'll go to our family, friends' house, and we'll meet them. We'll exchange sweets, no? Yes. There are two main kinds of the festival celebrated in India. Celebrating together, religious festival and harvest festival. Okay, India is the land of, yes, obviously India, in India many different people of religions are living in India, right? Yes, let's see some religious festivals. In your textbook, see page number 16. Religious festival. India is a land of many religions. People of different religions have a special days which they celebrate as festivals. Yes, many religions are staying in India, and each and every religions having one special day. That special day we celebrate as a festival, right? Yes. Let's see the Diwali. Where is Diwali? Yeah, see. Diwali is a festival of the light. Diwali is a festival of light. It's celebrated by the Hindus. People decorate their houses with the light, diyas and candle. They pray to Goddess Lakshmi and Lord Ganesha. They wear new clothes and exchange sweets and gifts with the friends and the family. Yes, if Diwali comes, means what we will do? We'll bring so many crackers and also we'll put diyas. Yes, candles, we'll celebrate, we'll decorate nicely our home, right? Yes, in that time, we praise to Lord Ganesha and Goddess Lakshmi. Yes, we'll meet two family members, we'll meet two our friends, we'll go to their house and we'll exchange sweets. Yes or no? But see, in Diwali, many people burst the crackers, right? That's very dangerous. How? Because when you burst that crackers, that smoke will come out, right? Because of that smoke, our air will become polluted, right? Pollutant. That's why, because of the burst cracker, our air will become pollution. So don't burst the crackers. And even when it burst, then sound will come. That sound may cause very danger for our ears and also for our pets and animals. Is it clear? Yes. While bursting, we should be careful. Yes, in Diwali, what we will do? We will bring new, we will buy new clothes, we'll wear, yes, we'll meet to all, we'll go to friend's house, we'll exchange sweets and gifts. Yes, like that only Eid. Eid is celebrated by the Muslim at the end of the Ramzan, which is the holy month of fasting. People go to the mosque to offer prayers. They meet their family and friends and wish to each other by saying Eid Mubarak. Wear new clothes and make a special dish that called Sevan on this day. Yes, this Eid is celebrated by the Muslim. On that day, people go to mosque, okay, to pray their offers, to offer their prayers, and also they meet to each other. They will meet to friends, family members, and they wish to them by saying Eid Mubarak. On this special day, what they will prepare a special dish, okay, that is called Sevan. Okay, on this day they prepare a special food and they will exchange with their family and also with their friends, okay. On that day, they wear new clothes. They'll go here, their aunt's house, their uncle's house, and also their family member's house. They'll celebrate nicely, okay? And next come to the Guru Purab, okay? Guru Purab is a religious festival of the Sikhs. It is also celebrated to mark the birthday of the Sikh Gurus. People decorate their houses with the lights. They offer prayers and serve others in Gurudwara. They wear new clothes and greet their family and friends. Yes, like others also, Guru Purab also, what, it's a religious festival of the Sikh peoples, okay. That's why they will call this Guru Purab. On that day, Sikh Guru's birthday was there. That's why they the mark of the birthday, that's why they are celebrating the Guru Purab. They gave a name to that festival, the mark of the birthday of Sikh Gurus, they call Guru Purab. Okay, on that day also Sikh people go to the Gurudwara and they will offer their prayers. Okay, they offer their prayers on Gurudwaras and serve to others. Okay, and that day also they wear new clothes. Yes, and greet their family. Christmas. Next is Christmas. Christmas is a what festival of the Christians. It is celebrated every year on 25th December, the birthday of Jesus Christ, on 24th December. What evening? On 24th December, people celebrate Christmas evening. This day, they decorate their houses with the lights. They also decorate a Christmas tree. They greet each other and exchange gifts and cake. Children believe that Santa Claus give them present on Christmas. Yes, Christmas when we are celebrating on December 25th, every year on December 25th we celebrate the Christmas day. On that day, you know, before one day on 24th December, from that time only evening that people start celebrating the Christmas. Yes, it is the religious festival of the Christians. Yes, and that day, what the people will do? They wear new clothes, they will go to church, right? And they will wear new clothes and they exchange sweets and gifts and also cake. Their special thing is what? Cake. On that day, Christians what? Exchange cake with their friends and their family. Okay. And also, like that only, see, we are now, these four are religious festival. Let's talk about the harvest festival. Harvest means what? It's the time when the farmer gather ripe the crops from the field and sell them. Okay, what they will do, see here. Harvest festival is the time of the year when farmer gather ripe crops from the field and sell them. There are many harvest festivals celebrated in India. These festivals celebrated the good harvest after many months of hard work. Yes, see, if somewhere we are getting food means it's come like that only, it will come like that only. No, because of the hard work of the farmer, then only we will get the good food with from them, right? Like that only. Harvest means what? The special day when the farmer ripe all the fruits from the field, and when that food is ready, then they will what? They will take out from the plants, and also they will sell them in the shop, or people, those will come and they will take. Or in India, there are like religious many harvest festivals also is there. That festival when will come? After many months of the hard work from farmer. Okay, let's talk about the few harvest festivals. First is Pongal. Pongal is the harvest festival of the Tamil Nadu. Pongal is the harvest festival of the what? Tamil Nadu. Yes. It is celebrated in January every year. People make Pongal rice on this day. Yes, Pongal is celebrated by the Tamil Nadu. Okay, in Tamil Nadu, and they prepare a special food. That is what? Pongal rice. And this festival celebrated in January. Pongal, right? Like other festival also, like Pongal also, it's a harvest festival. And in this day also, they prepare a special food that called what? Pongal rice. Again, Onam. Onam is the harvest festival of the Kerala. Onam is the harvest festival of the Kerala. People decorate elephants and take out processions. Boat race are also held. King Mahabali is remembered with respect on this day. Yes, Onam is a harvest festival of the what? Kerala. Yes, on that day, what they will do? They decorate the elephants. What they will do? They decorate the elephants and take out the procession. They will go around their town. They go around their cities. Okay, they take out the procession, and what? Boat race also will be held there. They respect to King Mahabali. They, because of their memory, means by remembering the King Mahabali, they celebrate the Onam festival in Kerala. Bihu. Next is Bihu. Bihu is celebrated in Assam. People celebrate Bihu at three different time of the year: spring, autumn, and winter. In Bihu, people, ladies, women used to wear new sarees, colorful sarees. They will dance, they will sing, and after that, this Bihu, you know, is celebrated in Assam. That too in three, what? Three times. First is what? Autumn, winter, and also in spring. Bihu is celebrated in Assam, and Bihu is at three different times. Three different time it will come, that when spring, autumn, and winter. Lohri. Next is Lohri. Lohri, North India or Punjab. See, Lohri is celebrated every year in the month of the January. Even this Pongal also celebrated in January only, and Lohri also celebrated in January every year. It is a harvest festival of the North India, especially Punjab. People light bonfires and celebrate with groundnut, corn, and jaggery. Yes. Lohri is which people are celebrating? Who are celebrating Lohri? Punjab peoples, North Indians are celebrating this Lohri. Yes, and in this, you know, bonfire means what? Something, you know, they will keep like, they will keep all the sticks like this, and there will be big fire. They will put big fire with bonfire, corn, and jaggery means what? Sugar cane. Okay, sugar cane, those all things, with those all things they will celebrate the Lohri festival. So these all are what? Pongal, Onam, Bihu, and Lohri are the harvest festivals. And religious festival means Diwali, Eid, Guru Purab, and the Christmas. Understand? So, important day, let's talk about these important days. You know, in all over in our country, see, Independence Day, Republic Day and Gandhi Jayanti are celebrating. But, let's talk about first, Independence Day. Independence, some special days are celebrated by the people all over the country. Yes, in all over the country, some important days are celebrating, okay? And these are Independence Day, Republic Day and the Gandhi Jayanti. On that special day, what they will do, people host the national flag, they sing national anthem, yes or no? Yes, they celebrate these all the important days. And also see, on Republic Day, on Independence Day, you know what, when we got independence means freedom from the British rule, we got on 15th August 1947, that time we got freedom from the British rule. In our earlier days, British were used to rule us, right? From in 1947, with the leaders of the freedom fighters, we got independence on the 15th August, okay? And on 15th August 1947, India got the freedom from the British rule. Independence Day is celebrated every year on 15th August to celebrate our freedom. The Prime Minister hosts the national flag at the Red Fort in Delhi, New Delhi. Yes, on this day, what Prime Minister will host the national flag? Where? In the Red Fort, at Red Fort in New Delhi. Okay. Let's talk about the Republic Day. Republic Day is celebrated every year on 26th January. Republic Day is celebrated every year on 26th January. India became a republic on 26th January 1950. 26th January 1950, India became a republic. On that day, in a republic, people vote and choose their own leaders. There are a grand parade in New Delhi on this day. In New Delhi, grand parade will be there in the New Delhi. On that, in republic, people vote and they can choose their own leaders on republic. When we got republic, 26th January 1950. These days you should fix in your mind, okay? Let's talk about the Gandhi Jayanti. Gandhi Jayanti is celebrated every year on 2nd October. It is the birthday of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of the nation. He was an important leader who helped us gain freedom from the British rule. Yes, Gandhiji helped a lot to get the freedom from the British rule. Yes, and he celebrated on, and his birthday is celebrated on 2nd October. On that day we call Gandhi Jayanti. Not only Gandhiji, there were many freedom fighters like Chacha Nehru. These all the members helped to get freedom from the British rule, okay? Don't be confused on these days, okay? See, independence on 15th August 1947, okay? Then our country got freedom from the British rule. Republic Day, when we are celebrating? 26th January 1950. Gandhi Jayanti in 2nd October. So, in this chapter, we have learned many things, right? About our family and joint family, like extended or joint family, large family, and also festivals, what are religious festivals, what are harvest festivals, and also these important days. I hope you all understood, right? So thank you very much. Stay home, stay safe.